Hey everybody, Michael Prettyman here. I've got an announcement for you, and this is going to be kind of interesting. We had an announcement almost a year ago to the date, and some of the same stuff applies. So everything that you see in this announcement is going to apply to what's happening this year. So this will be fun to watch. So check this out. Hey everybody. This is Grace Works Church, and this is Michael Prettyman, and this is
Bella Paris,
and we are going to do a very quick Christmas Eve trivia. Fire away.
Top five questions. Number one, what day is Christmas Eve?
What day is Christmas Eve? December the 23rd.
Wrong, it's December 24th. Next question. What time are we having the Christmas Eve service?
What time are we having the Christmas Eve service at Grace Works? We are having it at 5 p.m.
Correct.
Yes. All right. Okay.
How long will the service be at Grace Works?
Oh, how long is the service going to be? Well, Tony and Bill are speaking, so it's probably going to be at least like 3 hours or something. Is that right? 3 hours?
No.
Okay.
It's actually 30 minutes.
30 minutes. Okay, so 30 minutes. Okay, you got another question for me?
Yes. All right. The last one.
Last question.
Will we be having communion, candle lights, and music?
I'm going to say that we're going to have candle lighting.
That is correct, but it is all of the above.
We're having all the above.
We will be having communion, candle lighting, and music.
So we're having communion, candle lighting, and music. All right. Now, a couple of announcements to add to that is on the last Sunday of 2021, which is December the 26th, and the first Sunday of 2022, which is January the 2nd, we are going to be only having one combined service, both of those mornings at 10:30 a.m. So if you're a 9 o'clock person, you won't have a 9 o'clock service those two Sundays, December the 26th and January 2nd, 10:30 a.m. only. Now I'm gonna let present day Michael Prettyman and Bella Paris close this out. I am Michael Prettyman.
I am Bella Paris.
You have a wonderful day, and we wish you a Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year.
She did that last year. See ya.
Gosh, if you were talented, I don't know what we would do with all that. Love you, man. I don't see the general here yet. Did he come in? He may be under the weather, but General Bill Lee, he just goes by the nickname General. He took this photograph that is at the front. And if you will notice, that sun is perfectly aligned with the peak of the cross. He stood out there forever trying to get just in the right place, the right distance, and the camera at the right angle. So it's to be commended. And outside in the lobby, there are several stacks of these, but please pick up a card. And if you want to pick up a couple to give one to someone else, and just as you do so, and when you see Bill, express gratitude to him. This will be hanging in the hallway. It's been there for a couple of weeks, but we wanted to dedicate it today and give thanks, and thought it would be appropriate to do so as we light our Advent candles. And two of our new members, David and Linda Kittle, are coming, and they have an extended family here with them this morning to do our reading and candle lighting.
Gotta get the glasses here, okay? Here we go.
When the angel had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." They hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there was the baby lying in the manger. After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished.
Right.
Thank you, David and Linda. One of the, you know, people ask about our church sometimes when they come, and what do they have to do? The only thing you have to do is be able to light 4 candles. So you are now officially members of Graceworks. Folks, it's so good to have you with us today. Would you join me in a word of prayer? And if you read our daily bread devotion, you will recognize some of my words this morning. Fathers, we come to this special day, and our choir members sing your praises, lead us in rejoicing and celebrating. We give honor and glory to you, Lord. Thank you for being there in the difficult times of our lives, and thank you for enhancing the wonderful times of our lives. And teach us, God, to wait on you. Remember us, Lord, today. Remember us, Lord, tomorrow. Remember us, Lord, in the year to come. And now we remember you as we worship you in Christ's name. Amen. Amen. Welcome, and I guess Michael's going to, we've got a song coming up for everybody stands and sings. You're going to come back and then, all right.
For a kickoff song this morning. Thank you so much, Tani. That really woke us up during sound check this morning, and we're so glad that you guys are here with us this morning. I feel like I should put a disclaimer on this service this morning. We have had computer crashes all morning long. Things have not been to work. Screens have been cutting out. The mouse, everybody knows what a mouse is. I'm not talking about the rodent, but the mouse hasn't been, you know, functioning this morning. Not everything that could go wrong, but a lot of things haven't been working, so we apologize if we have any technical difficulties this morning. That technology, a blessing and a curse, all in one. But you know what? We're going to honor and we're going to glorify the Lord this morning, no matter what happens. And we're going to pray that things work out okay. We're here to worship Him this morning, and we are thankful that you are here this morning. I'm going to ask Gary to come on up here. We're going to get started in just a second, but welcome to Graceworks Church this morning. And I see a lot of familiar faces in the crowd. I know we have a couple of faces that aren't quite as familiar. If you are visiting with us this morning, You're our special guest this morning. We have a lot of music this morning, and we have a Facebook Live audience who is watching as well. So welcome to our Facebook Live audience. And I'm going to ask you if you would go ahead and stand up this morning. Make sure I'm not skipping over anything yet. I've got my service order here. And what I'd like for you to do is turn around and wave at somebody this morning and tell them, welcome to Grace Works Church. And while you're doing that, we're going to get started with a familiar Christmas song. Y'all wave at each other, and we'll start with the angels we have heard on high.
The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end."
Your baby boy would one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon your baby boy would give sight to a blind man. And Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand. Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know the blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the your baby boy is Lord of all creation. And Mary, did you know,
did you know
that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect plan? And this sleeping child you're holding is the great
This is how the birth of Jesus the Messiah came about. His mother was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit.
Surprised at where this road had taken him, 'cause never in a million lives would he have dreamed of Bethlehem. And standing at the manger, he saw with his own eyes the message from the angel come to life. And Joseph said, "Why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. And why him with all the rulers in the world? And why here inside this stable with hay? And why her? She's just an ordinary girl. And now I'm not a one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to say had come as he deserved. There would have been no Bethlehem and no lowly shepherds at his birth. But Joseph knew the reason. Savior in his arms.
He must have thought,
why me? I'm just a simple man of trade, and why him with all the rulers in the world? And why here? Inside this stable filled with hay, and why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to say. Such a strange way, yet this is such a strange way to save the world.
Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way. And the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed.
This is a song that has become popular at Christmas time, and I'm not supposed to be on stage singing this morning. Lydia Richard was supposed to be here this morning singing, and last night her grandmother passed away. And she couldn't be here this morning, and so why don't y'all help me out with the song as we sing it together? It goes like this.
I've heard about this baby boy who's come to earth to bring us joy, and I just want to sing this song to ya. It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift. With every breath I'm singing, hallelujah. 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 Came to Bethlehem expecting child. They searched the inn to find a place for you are coming soon. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only son was born. Oh, hallelujah. Star shone bright up in the east to Bethlehem. Bethlehem, the wise men three came many miles and journeyed along for you. And to the place at which you were, their frankincense and gold and myrrh they gave to you.
Could we just pause for a second and pray for the peace of Lydia's family, our grandmother's Grace Garner. Father, we thank you so much that even though we avoid death, fear it, don't understand it, it is your solution as to how to get us out of a world of sin, a body that has aged, a heart that longs to go home. So be with Grace's family today, giving them the peace that I know was in her heart. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. After Joseph had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife. What is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins."
Thank you.
Mary was greatly troubled at the angel's words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel. "I'm a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her.
I have tried.
Well, I want to give you guys a moment to go to the Lord and take a moment just to make an altar of where you are right now, and let's just talk to the Lord. This has been a wonderful worship service, and I love seeing it all come together. And I praise the Lord that we've not had any technology issues yet. I pray mostly that the Lord is honored and glorified and lifted up. No matter what happens in the service this morning, we're here to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, who ultimately became our Savior, and the reason we have a hope beyond this life, the reason we will be reunited once again with our loved ones, and we'll be able to meet our Savior face to face one day. So right now, just take a moment where you are. Bow your heads and close your eyes. And just take time to pray and thank the Lord for something this morning. We're going to sing one more song here in just a moment. Tamara's going to sing it for us, but don't miss this opportunity. We come here this morning to celebrate you. God, we sing these songs about you and the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. And God, we just can't thank you enough for all the things that you do for us. And God, as we come here this morning, I pray as Tony brings the message here, God, that you would speak through him. God, that you would give him the words to say this morning. And I pray that you have been pleased with everything that has been said and done here. God, we acknowledge that you are the King of Kings. God, you are the Lord of Lords. And once again, we thank you for this gift, the best Christmas gift of all time, the gift of Jesus Christ, your Son. So God, right now, it's my privilege to speak on behalf of every person in this room and anyone who may be watching online, God, when I tell you that we love you and we thank you for the gift of salvation we have only through Jesus Christ. It's in Jesus' name we pray all these things. Amen.
Amen.
Good morning. I have the privilege today to share with you from God's Word. And I don't know how in the world Bill Owens could stand up here and read Scripture without preaching after hearing all of you sing. I mean, that is so inspiring. And you know, the most moving part of it all, as I stood in the back of the room and I heard Michael sing the Christmas Hallelujah, is to look around and see all of you participating. What a beautiful offering of praise to our King. And so thank you so much for that example you set before us. And I want to say a word of thanks to Bill, the General Lee, for this beautiful portrait right here that's before us, the light of the world. What an inspiration that is. In December of 2015, my wife Lana and my three daughters decided rather than exchanging gifts, we would save that money and put it towards a Christmas trip to New York City. We boarded the plane in the month of December. We went to Times Square, and it was everything you could imagine and more. We walked the streets. We saw all the storefront displays. We saw all the lights, all the decorations, the big Christmas trees. It was an incredible experience. And at one point, one evening, we found ourselves walking through Rockefeller Center, the big ice rink and Christmas tree. And we noticed that there was hundreds, if not thousands, of people gathered on the plaza. And they were looking at the building, Saks Fifth Avenue. Well, of course, everybody's looking, and so I joined right in. And I could see on the side of the building, made in the form of lights, it was like a timer, a clock. And it was counting down. And we stood there for a few minutes, and all of a sudden, this 6 to 7 story building lit up. And on the face of this building was a light show synchronized to music. I had no idea what was about to happen. I was caught off guard. I've got just a clip of this year's light show at Saks Fifth Avenue, and I just want to share a taste of this with you. Jackie, would you share that? Imagine what we experienced. 6-7 stories high, and it's just going crazy up there. And we sat mesmerized by what was happening. It caught me off guard. I was surprised, excited, all in one package over something that was not expected, something that was rare, unique. In other words, I was experiencing a sense of wonder. The wonder, that which had caught me off guard, I wasn't counting on to happen. And when it was over, myself included in the group of thousands, all of a sudden started cheering. We're cheering for lights on a building and music. But there was this just sense of wonder as we took all of this in. And this morning, just in the brief time I have with you, I want to share the importance of having a sense of wonder when it comes to Christmas. One of the best examples in our secular Christmas tradition is the exchanging of gifts, opening gifts. And unfortunately, in my family, it's gotten to where we tell people what we want. We get the gift, we open it up, we know what's in there. But have you ever received a gift from someone you weren't expecting? You ever received that gift and you had no idea what it was, and you open it up and you went, oh, wow. That is a great example of wonder. Of wonder, that excitement and surprise that we get to experience. Well, there's an example in Scripture, one of the best examples of wonder, found in the Christmas story. And it can be seen in none other than the shepherds and their, what they experienced and how they had this sense of wonder. This month of December, as we approach the Christmas Eve celebration, we've been focusing on recapturing, regaining that which was lost. And for many of us, the sense of wonder has been lost. The sense of wonder of what God has done through His Son. Would you look with me at Scripture today that I will read from Luke chapter 2, beginning with verse 8. And in the same region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom He is pleased." And when the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem, and let us see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph, and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning the child. And all who heard it, they wondered at what the shepherds had told them. They wondered at what the shepherds had told them. They had that sense of excitement and surprise because they had a unique message to share. And as we look at this and consider this in just the brief moment we've got here, I want you to see why having this sense of wonder is so important to us. As you look at this passage, you see the persons that received this first message were shepherds. Now keep in mind, shepherds were known as outcasts. Many times they were called thieves. They had such a bad reputation, they were not allowed in the temple. They were not even allowed to be a witness in the court. They were outcasts, undeserving. And this is who the angels appeared to first, to share the message. Notice once they heard the message of the angels, how did they approach Jesus? Scripture tells us they approached Him with great haste. They hurried. They hurried. They were passionate in this search. They didn't just stand around and say, "Hey, did y'all see those angels? That was cool." No, they didn't sit there and say, "Do you really think what they're saying is going to happen?" No. Did they make excuses? "Well, I've got these sheep to take care of. I can't leave my sheep." No. As they heard the angels, they didn't delay. They didn't drag their feet. I can only imagine, as it says, they made haste. They hurried. They were running across the countryside. For what they had seen in the angels, for the message they had heard, they wanted to find out what it was. And Scripture tells us they hurried. Now let me ask you, looking at their example of wonder and what they've experienced, they approached Jesus. How do you and I approach Jesus? Do we have the same passion to seek Him out? Do we open up God's Word to learn who He is, what He has done, with the same intensity? Do we get on our knees and pray passionately because we have this sense of wonder? For you see, wonder, it stimulates. It encourages us in our approaching of God. And when we lose that sense of wonder, it's going to impact how we approach God. Wonder is so vital, so important. But what is it that created the wonder for the shepherds? Was it a fact that these angels showed up on the scene? It says they were afraid. They were trembling. The first words the angel uttered, "Fear not." Can you imagine what it must have been like to witness the angel standing before them with the message? But Scripture goes on to tell us. It says there wasn't just one. There wasn't three. There was a multitude. An army of the heavenly host. I can only imagine the sky was filled with angels. Keep in mind, they've been waiting for the birth of a Savior. the Son of God becoming human flesh. I wouldn't be surprised if all heaven didn't open up. All the angels are out. And the sky is filled from horizon, across the horizon. Because the Savior has been born. What a sight that must have seen. That had to shock the shepherds. They weren't expecting this. And maybe the wonder was created by the message. The message, a sign. You're going to find this baby. He's wrapped in swaddling clothes. He's lying in a manger. How many of you put your kids in a feeding trough? No. But what was the message of the angels? He said, in the city of David, he's going to be born the Savior of the world. The Savior, Christ, the Messiah, the Lord, God, coming in human form. At the heart of the message of Christmas, we need a sense of wonder. For this wonder, it leads us to get to the heart of the message of Christmas. With all the distractions of Christmas, wonder helps us get to that message. It's so important. Wonder also, it serves as the fuel to go and tell about the Savior. When's the last time you experienced something hard to explain? When's the last time you experienced something unexpected? Did you just kind of keep it to yourself? No. No. You went out and told everybody you could find that would listen to you, didn't you? Shepherds, it says, after they saw the baby, they went out and they shared what they experienced. They shared the wonder they had in the Christ child. And everybody that heard it, what does Scripture say? They wondered. They wondered at what the shepherds had to tell them. Here you see the gospel message in the life of the shepherds. Someone so undeserving, such as shepherds, that's us. And the excitement, the surprise, God loves us and gave His Son. There's a song that we sing at Christmas season, very familiar. All of you could probably sing it if you were asked to do so. His song is Joy to the World. Joy to the World. It's a song of celebration. But there's this last verse that I find interesting. Often it's kind of we pass over the words because we've memorized it. We go through the motions of it all. But this last verse is often misunderstood. It goes something like this. It says, He rules the world with truth and grace. And He makes the nations prove in the glories of His righteousness and the wonders of His love. The wonders of His love. The wonders of His love. And the wonders of His love. Wonders of His love. The Christmas message is the wonders of God's love. In other words, the surprise, the excitement to the undeserving is brought on by the unique, the unexpected, the arrival of God in the form of His Son, Jesus, our Savior, our Lord. That's wonder. Do you have that sense of wonder? If we don't have that sense of wonder, how can we share that with the world? Do you have that sense of wonder? Have you lost that sense of wonder? It's so important in the Christmas season that we make sure we have regained, recaptured, if we have lost it. Would you pray with me? Father in heaven, we thank You for Your Word. We thank You for the opportunity to gather for worship. We thank You for the songs, the testimonies that we have heard. And Father, now we give thanks to You for the amazing wonder of Your great love for us. Father, may You instill this wonder in us. May we take and share it with a world that is so in need. Father, be glorified and our lives be glorified, and our song be glorified in your word, and be glorified in Jesus, your Son, our Savior and Lord. For we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Would you stand with me as we continue to worship in song? Please join in singing. If you've got a commitment decision you need to make, I'll be here at the front. But most importantly, share that sense of wonder with Him.
Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Sing Christ the Lord, for He alone is worthy. For He alone is worthy. For He alone is worthy. Christ the Lord. Now lift this one up here. Here we go.
Thank you so much for your being here, your presence, but also your participation in making great our God. Thank you again. As you head out today, have a seat for just a moment, if you don't mind. No, I'm not going to keep preaching. I had my time. It's always the person on the back row that appreciates that. And then they start pointing fingers at someone else. Just going back to the idea of how we approach God. We make available to you devotionals. There's our daily bread, which is a daily devotional. There are reading plans for this upcoming year, reading through the Bible, reading through the New Testament. We're just seeing the big picture of Scripture. I hope you make the most of those. Those are an assistance to you. But if you don't have that relationship with Him, if you don't have that sense of wonder, those aren't going to make it happen. But take advantage of these. Spend time in the Word. Spend time in prayer. And may God bless you. May He create a sense of awe in His coming and being our Savior and Lord. As you go out this week, I pray that you will continue to minister to one another. As already mentioned, Grace Garner, member of our church, passed away Saturday. And there are many generations. I think there are four generations of her family that are part of this church. And Heritage Funeral Home will have the arrangements. Those will be planned and made out this afternoon. You can check Heritage Funeral Home, East Brainerd Road. Check their website and you'll see the arrangements for that. So be in prayer for Grace's family as they go through the season, celebrating the homegoing, celebrating something that we're looking forward to with a great sense of wonder. May God bless you. And may you go about this Christmas season overwhelmed by the unexpected gift of our Savior Jesus.